I would like to play first. Sounds pretty good. That's fine. No one drop, but I got a two drop and a couple things to put on it, so. Am I ever going to get a one drop into an aura in this draft? Who's to say? Well, putting auras on that guy is reasonably good. Know if it's better than playing Hoplite. I could next turn go like, or like in a later turn, I guess, not necessarily next turn, like put Chosen by Helioid. And I'm gonna Hoplite. It does work well with this guy though, because the guys get haste. I just want to start ordealing ASAP, I think. Probably chosen on the Crusader. Next turn. Let's see what we draw. We'll see what he does. Nothing. All right. Probably not gonna bother to attack with that and just bin it, but I'll attack with this guy to get the extra damage. Could have like Last Breath or plus two here. So probably has plus two. So maybe it was stupid not to put that on there. Well, wish I had a follow-up to that, but I don't. Yeah, that was probably bad on my part, getting a little greedy. He's pretty screwed. I don't really need an extra 1/1. He's a lot less screwed now, but he was like screwed based on what I had, so. Pretty stupid, I think. Didn't need the 1/1. I mean, there's some logic to it because I get an extra plus one by being able to attack with that. Like, I do get a lot of value out of putting that on that guy, but I was only really thinking about Last Breath at first there. But yeah, I should have thought about Battlewise Valor. Do I want to let him trade the Hoplite? Trade for the Hoplite? I think I do. I think that's fine. I still don't really want to just bin the 1/1, but then again, if he just it takes 1, 2, 3, let's take a ton of damage if he just blocks that. Yeah, that's alright. It would still be right to block the 1/1, I think. And just be able to block the Hoplite the next turn. Don't know why I didn't play that there. I was like waiting to bestow this, but that doesn't make any sense. Should just run it out there. As soon as I have six, like, why'd I do that? Alright, so can trade up with that. I don't even really want to. I'd rather just play the Minotaur. So, just gonna attack with these two. Yep, should have played that Spear Point. Could have got in there for. Well, I would attack with that too, then I got in for one more damage, basically. I guess I just tackle everything. I'm okay spending a turn with the satyr here, I think. Gets that giant guy out of my way. Also, reasonable chance he's gonna double block this borderland minotaur to get it out of the off the board. It's the most threatening thing. Okay. I can deal with that. Continues to not have black mana, which seems pretty unlucky for all the lands. He's drawn lands, like he done what he can kind of thing, you know? Alright. Well, I don't draw a way to cast Rage, but let's see here. I'm gonna get a 1-1, so this he has to block. Probably like, I mean he could trade, probably just, well, let's say whatever he trades. Do. So what's the worst thing that can happen? Is he trades, he blocks a 2-2. He still takes. Alright, so he has to block this. Block a 2-2. So I still got a haste guy, so it's still 5. So yeah, I think he's dead. He's not dead, then I did math wrong, and result. But I think he has to be dead. Like the two biggest things are that and the 4-3, so 5 without that. Man. Well, he has two emissaries. Stealing the one is actually pretty sweet. The one that taps things. It's like stealing two things. I don't know if that's better than one of these other cards. Again, I just don't really. It's like taking out combo pieces. Alright, yeah, we'll stay.